Cherry Creek kids, thank you for taking the time today to learn a little bit from God's Word. In Hebrews 4, verse 12, it says that God's Word is sharper than any two-edged sword, and it is active and alive. And when we take the time out to learn about God through His Word, that has the power to change us and make us more like Christ. And that is so important because we want to be able to be like Christ so that we can share Christ with others. So today, before we get started, I want to encourage you to minimize distractions around you. Maybe that means getting rid of your toys around you. Maybe that means turning off some noise. But whatever that means, it might also be a good idea to grab a pair of headphones, plug those in, and put those on, so that you can really focus in on what God has to say to you today. So, before we get started, let's go ahead and bow our heads and close your eyes and let's pray together. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank you for this time that we can be together, that we can learn about you today together. Please help us to really take to heart your words, Lord. Just plant those seeds in us and allow us to grow them into your spiritual fruit, Lord, that your Holy Spirit will plant those words of life into us and that they will become love and joy and peace and patience and kindness and goodness that we can share with others, with our family and our friends, Lord. So just take this time that we are meeting together to learn about your word and bless it. In your name we pray. Amen. Have a great lesson, kids.
King Herod Agrippa was persecuting believers in the church. He killed James, one of Jesus' disciples. When the king saw how happy this made the Jews, he arrested Peter too. The king put Peter in prison and assigned groups of soldiers to keep guard. While Peter was in prison, other believers in the church prayed and asked God to help him.
The king planned for Peter to be killed. The night before his execution, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers. He was tied up with chains, and other soldiers stood guard at the gate of the prison. All of a sudden, an angel of the Lord appeared, and a bright light shone in Peter's prison cell. The angel struck Peter on the side and woke him up. "Quick, get up," the angel said. The chains fell off of Peter's wrists. The angel told Peter to get dressed, so Peter put on his sandals and his cloak. Then he followed the angel. Peter wasn't sure what was happening. He thought he was seeing a vision.
The angel led Peter out of the prison, past the guards, through the gate, and onto the streets. Then the angel left. When Peter looked around, he realized the Lord had rescued him from prison and from certain death. Peter hurried to the house of Mary, the mother of John Mark. Believers had gathered there to pray. When Peter knocked at the door, a servant named Rhoda answered. She heard Peter's voice and she was so happy. She rushed back inside. "Peter is here. He is at the door," she announced.
But the others didn't believe her. "You're crazy," they said. But Peter kept knocking, and when they opened the door, they could hardly believe it. Peter motioned to them to be quiet, and he told them how the Lord had rescued him from prison. "Tell James and the other brothers about this," Peter said. Then he left. When the sun came up, the soldiers at the prison couldn't figure out what happened to Peter, and the king punished the soldiers because Peter had escaped.
God answered the people's prayers for Peter. God had a plan for Peter and the church, and he rescued Peter from his enemies. Peter knew he would face death because he believed in Jesus, but he kept going so he could share the good news of the gospel.
Hey there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Roman from Millersville, Pennsylvania asks,
how does God answer our prayers? Does he always answer us?
Roman, God always hears our prayers. That's the first thing we have to understand, that when we pray to God, when we talk with God, he always hears us. He never has his ears closed. He's never asleep. He's never not paying attention. He hears you. He listens to you always. Now, how does he answer our prayers? Well, the technical answer is yes, he always answers our prayers. But sometimes people ask that question, and what they mean is this: does God always answer our prayers the way we want him to? And the answer for that is no, he does not. God answers our prayers the best way for us and the way that brings him glory. So if we ever make the mistake of praying something that would not be best for us or something that would not glorify him, even if we don't understand that, God will not answer that with a yes. That will be a no, because he wants to give, again, what's best for us and what brings him the most glory. There are times as well that God may answer with a yes, but it may not be right away. So we may be praying for something and it's good and it would bring God glory, but it's not the right timing. So it might feel like God has not heard us or answered us, but he has. Again, he always hears us. And the answer is yes, but it's not yet. So that's the big idea. When we pray, we have to keep in mind God is listening. He will always answer. But here's the other thing I just really want to get on your radar real quick while we have the chance. When we pray, we also need to be changing ourselves. We're drawing closer to God. So don't treat prayer just as a way for God to act. Prayer should draw us closer to his heart. And many times when we pray, we should be changed because we're understanding who God is and we want to love him and live for him better. So prayer actually is designed to change us more than anything else. So here's a question back for you. How might not getting something you really want actually be better for you?
Ah, the culture of Europe. The creatures of Africa. The, cuisine of Asia. Yes, the world is a big, beautiful, crazy collection of tribes and tongues and tastes and, well, whatever that is. If you wanted to see it all, you could hop on a really slow ship and circle the globe. Or you could just come here, Toronto, Canada.
Most of the people we have here in Toronto, they are not from here. So in Toronto, you can find people from every country in the world, literally.
That is J.D. Fasolino. He and his family moved to Toronto from sunny South America. That's probably why the very first thing they noticed when they got here was the weather.
I'm from a tropical country, so my first time seeing the snow was in Canada. So it was a beautiful moment. I'm not gonna lie, there was a tear.
But the Fasolinos didn't move to Toronto for the snow. They came because they'd heard there are lots of Spanish-speaking people here who don't know about Jesus. And they had heard right. There are lots of those people here, but they're not easy to find.
In Toronto, there's actually a Korean town, a Chinatown, Greek town, but there's no Hispanic town. Venezuelans, Colombians, Cubans, we are here. We are all over the place. You just need to know where to look for us.
Where to look, it turned out, was a mushroom farm like this one out in the suburbs. This is where hundreds of Hondurans and Guatemalans had come looking for work.
These are people that they have left behind, family, friends. They left behind everything just to come here to work. So they feel alone, and there was no Hispanic church at all, not at all. And that's how we decided to start a Hispanic church because someone needed to look for these people.
Hi kids, I hope you enjoyed your lesson from God's Word today. I hope that you feel like you can take it to your school or use it at home or when you're playing with friends, and that it will continue to help you to grow in God's grace and be more like Christ. I want you to bow your heads with me and close your eyes so we can close in prayer today and thank God for our lesson from His Word. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank you so much for allowing these kids to open their hearts to your word today. Lord, I ask that what they learn today will stick with them and that they will be able to continue to grow and learn from the lesson that was heard today. Lord, I ask that you will just give a special blessing to those listening today, that you will give them strength and wisdom and help them to know that you will never leave them nor forsake them, that you are always with them wherever they may go. And Lord, I ask that you remind them that they were created in your image and that they are very special in your eyes. Lord, thank you for creating each one of us so special and unique. In your name we pray. Amen. Hope you guys have a great day.